On this problem, we have a coiled spring used to shoot a block across a smooth surface, which is code for frictionless. And I have a mass on this thing. There's a lot of stuff hidden in this paragraph, so I'm going to get it out of there. The mass is 275 grams. I'm just going to change that to kilograms, 0.275 kilograms. The spring constant is 150 newtons per meter. I have the angle of elevation drawn into the picture already. My initial compression of the spring was 25 centimeters. So I want to get that in there. And then this dashed line over here is indicating the equilibrium length of the spring. Okay, good. And then part A is, what's the speed of the block right when it comes off the spring? So that's spring energy converted to kinetic energy. And then part B, what's the distance the block slides up the incline before coming to rest? And that's that kinetic energy being converted into gravitational potential energy. So there's going to be some final Y on this. And there's a lot of problems like this where there are different ways to get to the answer on part B. You could just say all the energy that used to be in the spring is now in the gravitational potential energy of that mass. In other words, going all the way from the beginning to picture number three. Alternatively, you could take the kinetic energy from part two and say that all turns into gravitational potential energy, and you're going to get the same answer. So I'll make a decision on that when I get there. Compute the speed of the block once the spring is expanded. All right, so we're really using conservation of energy now. There are no non-conservative forces acting, and for us, it's practically always friction. So it's just my total mechanical energy is conserved. That means the initial potential energy. Sometimes I'll use a notation of U for that. Sometimes I'll use a PE for that. I'll just use the PE notation this time. Plus my initial kinetic energy. That's going to be equal to the final mechanical energy, potential and kinetic. Okay, and then I have to kind of look at what's going on in this process, and a lot of these things in practice are going to turn out to be zero. Like, for example, in the initial state, we're starting from rest, which means there is no kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is 1/2 mv². If there's no V, then there's no kinetic energy. And then in my final state, which is right here, right, I'm in the second picture, there's no more spring potential energy going on. And gravitational potential energy is out of the picture because it's just a level surface. I can say it's zero in both beginning and end. So no spring potential there. So just very simply in this problem, the spring potential energy turns into kinetic. And that's what I see in the next step. 1/2 kx² That's the spring potential energy is equal to 1/2 mv², the final potential energy of the block. I'll even put an F on that V to say it's V final. And I can just go ahead and solve for V out of this, divide by M, and square root the result. kx² over m square rooted. So it's going to be the square root of k, that's 150, x initial, 25 centimeters, that's 0.25 meters squared, over my mass, which was 0.275 kilograms. And we'll smash those numbers real quick. And I get 5.84 meters per second. All right, compute the distance the block slides up this incline. There's kind of two parts to this problem. One is the energy conservation part. Whether you go from the second picture to the third or from the first to the third is up to you. And then the second part is the geometry part. So energy conservation can tell you the final y coordinate, because that's part of gravitational potential energy. But then you have to relate that to the sliding distance by using trigonometry. So I'm going to go ahead and just go from picture number one to picture number three. It doesn't really matter what happened in between. all the energy that was stored in that spring turns into the gravitational energy of the block at the end. And in practice, it's okay, as long as you have a really good intuition for a problem, it's okay to just say, all right, what was all my energy in the initial state? Oh yeah, it was a coiled spring. And then where's all the energy in the final state? There's only one thing going on because the spring is uncoiled and this thing is motionless. All I have is gravitational potential energy in the final state. It is important to know where your origin is. So I'm calling the ground level zero for the y-coordinate. And then my final y-coordinate is going to be just that y final. So that's what I'm trying to solve for. I could go ahead and solve for y final symbolically. It's kx initial squared over 2mg. So 150.25 squared over 2 times 0.275 times 9.8. And we'll smash the numbers real quick. And I get for y final 1.74 meters. All right, so the block slides a little less than two meters vertically, but how far does it slide horizontally as that's happening? And that's where the trig comes in. So this side of the triangle is 1.74 meters. But what I want is the hypotenuse. All right, so I have to use a trig function for that. And I see that the sine function is the one that is best adapted here. So the sine of 25 degrees is 1.74 meters over d. So d is going to be just multiplying it over here and then dividing by the sine of 25. 1.74 over sine 25. And I get a sliding distance of 4.12 meters. All right, again, there's kind of formal and informal approaches to energy conservation. And what I was trying to illustrate in part A is that you can always start out by saying, okay, E initial equals E final. Or if you have to generalize for there being some friction involved, you would write E initial plus the work done by friction equals E final. But in a lot of problems, it's just so much more intuitive than that. And you can just say, where did my energy come from? It was a coiled spring. Where did it end up? It was the height of this mass. So I was able to write this down in one step without going through the formalism here.